Hello everyone and welcome back to PA Academy. So this is the part 2 on the video series under Kirchhoff voltage law. So in the part 1 I explained what Kirchhoff voltage law is, and in that part 1 we didn't really use real values like we are having here. So this example we are going to be using real values to explain what Kirchhoff voltage law is all about. So if you are new here, please consider subscribing, and if you missed the part 1 of this video, there's a link in the description of this video to the part 1 of this particular one under Kirchhoff voltage law. Now, so in this circuit, we are asked to calculate we are given 3 questions under this circuit. The first one says, calculate the current in the circuit. So in this circuit, we are asked to calculate the current and using Kirchhoff voltage law. That's what we are going to be using. And then the second question says that what we should calculate the voltage drop across each resistor. So across the 8 ohm resistor and the 10 ohm resistor, what is the voltage drop across each of them? And then the third one is asking us to verify Kirchhoff voltage law, if the Kirchhoff voltage law is actually true. And remember what Kirchhoff voltage law states. It states that what the algebraic sum of all the voltage around any closed loop in a circuit is equals to zero. So we are going to be verifying that statement, if it's actually correct with respect to this particular circuit, when we get to the third part of this question. So with that, now let's start with the question one. So the question one says that we should calculate the current in the circuit. Now remember when I was talking in the part one, I said that the first step you should do is that what you draw, you decide the direction of your current that you want to pick. And personally, I like to choose start from the clockwise direction. So in clockwise direction, we are going to be having something like this. So this is going to be the direction of our current. I'll indicate it there. And then once you indicate the direction of your current that you want to work with, you can decide to choose a clockwise or anticlockwise. I said that in the part one. Now let's pick the polarity based on the direction of the current. Now I said for the voltage source, the polarity is not always influenced by the direction of the current. So for the voltage source, the longer side positive and then the shorter one negative. Same will apply here. This is plus and this is minus. Now but for other elements, based on the direction of the current, it will move from positive to negative. So in this direction, we are going to be having, this is going to be our plus, minus, and then for the 10 ohm resistors in this direction, so it's going from positive to negative. So now having done that, now let's start to calculate from one node. So let me call this is a node, this is also a node, then at this point, let's call this A, B, C, and then D. So starting from this node, remember, Kirchhoff code, voltage law is from one node straight to the other around a closed loop. So from A, B, C, D back to A is a closed loop. So from A now, if you are to move in this direction, applying Kirchhoff voltage law. So once we get here, remember the current here is what? Is I. We don't know the value. So I, and then it's moving from positive to negative. That is going to be A times I, and then with respect to the negative, from plus to minus, that will be minus. So this is for question one. So that will be minus 8i. So that is for this. That's the voltage here. So for this one now, remember, I've also explained this, but let me just say it again. Remember that voltage is V is equals to IR. So that's why we are having the I, which is the current. We don't know the value. That's why we are having it as I. And then the resistance is 8 ohms. So that gives us the value of the voltage, which is minus 8i. So let's continue. Then for this now, this is I. Current I is flowing through this 10 ohm resistor. And from positive to negative, that will be minus 10i. So that's sorted. And let's continue. If you look at it, for the voltage source, 20 is going from positive to negative. That is going to be minus 20. Now, we are not going to multiply 20 by the current. That's because this 20 is already in volts. This one is in resistance alone. That's why we are multiplying it with the current. But since this is already in volts, there's no need to multiply it with I. So that will give us minus 20. Look at it from plus to minus in the direction of current, plus to minus. So let's continue from C, go to D. Now we are on this 25 volts, the voltage source. So from minus to plus, remember from minus to plus, and that will give us plus. So that will be plus 25 is equals to zero. From that, we come back to point A. So there's no other element there. point A, and that is it here. So now let's simplify this. We have minus 8i minus 10i. So that will give us minus 18i. So okay, minus 18, 18i, then minus 25 plus 25 plus 5 is equals to 0. So if we should simplify this, we are going to be having minus 18i is equals to minus 5. So if we should divide both sides, if you should divide both sides by minus 18, so we are going to be having minus 18i over minus 18 is equals to minus 5 divided by minus 18. So, all right, we still have space down here. So this can cancel this, and then we are going to be having our I is equals to 0.278 amperes. Always remember your units. 0.278 amperes. Now, using Kirchhoff voltage law, we've been able to get the current that is flowing in this particular circuit as 0.278 amperes. And that answers question one, the current in the circuit. And since it is a series connection, you can see it's in series. That means the current here is 0.278, and the current flowing through this 10 ohm resistor is also 0.278 amperes. So that answers that of question one. Now let's look at question two. It says that we should calculate the voltage drop across each resistor. So that means this 8 ohm resistor, if a current of 0.278 is passing through it, what would be the total voltage at this point? And also, if a current of 0.278 amperes passing through this resistor of 10 ohm, what would be the voltage? Voltage drop across each resistor. So now for us to calculate, so this is for the question two. So this is one, and this is going to be for question two. So now let's start with that of the 8 ohm. So we are going to be having the voltage drop across the 8 ohm resistor. So I'll indicate it like this. We are going to be having it as, remember to calculate voltage, we have it voltage to be V is equals to IR. So that will be I times R, and then R is 8. So that will be giving us, we already gotten our I to be, that's our current to be 0.278 times 8. So if you multiply that, let's see. All right, so that will give us 2.2222 volts. Always remember your units. So that's for the voltage drop across the 8 ohm resistor. So now let's do that of the 10 ohm. So that'll be V, and then 10 ohm. That'll be V is equals to I times the resistance of the 10 ohm resistor. And that'll be 0.278 times 10. I hope you can still see it. Okay. And that's going to give us 2.78 volts. So with that, now we've been able to answer the question one and question two. This is the current in the circuit, and this is the voltage drop across the 8 ohm is 2.22, and the 10 ohms is equals to 2.78. Now let's look at the third one. Say we should verify what Kirchhoff voltage law, based on this circuit and the calculation we've done, we are going to verify if it is actually what Kirchhoff voltage law is all about. Maybe it's actually correct, and maybe this question is in line with that. So for us to do that, let me just rub this part off, and then we take note of some values. All right, from our calculation, we already know that our I current is what, 0.278 amperes. We already know that the voltage drop across the 8 ohm resistor is 2.22 volts, and then we already know that the voltage across the 10 ohm resistor is equals to 2.78 volts. So I can go ahead and rub everything off because of our space. So you can write this down, so that, because I want to rub this and this, I want to rub it off. All right, so welcome back. Now let's verify KVL. And remember that Kirchhoff voltage law says that what the algebraic sum of the voltage in a closed circuit, that is in this particular loop, now it should equals to zero. Now let's verify if it's going to give us zero. So let's bring back. Now let's use this. Now from A, if you remember that for this 8 ohm resistor, we've gotten the value to be 2.22 volts. But remember that is negative, that's from plus to minus, so that will be minus 2.22 volts. So let's continue. For the 10 ohm, we have the voltage drop here to be 2.78, but based on the direction that we are using, that is negative. So from plus to minus, that will be minus 2.78. So when we get here, this is already in volts already. So from plus to minus, and that's going to give us minus 20 volts. And then when you come here, this is another source here. From minus to plus, that's going to be us plus 25. So all things being equal, it's supposed to give us is equals to zero. So now let's see. By the time we have minus 2.22, minus 2.78, and minus 20, if you add this in your calculator, you are going to be having minus 25, then plus 25, and that will give us zero. So you can see that this circuit is in line with Kirchhoff voltage law that says that what the algebraic sum of current in a closed loop is equals to what, to zero. Now, in other words, what it simply means is that we can also say that the total voltage that is being generated by the voltage source, which is the battery, is also being used up by what, by the two resistors that we are having in the circuit. So if you have any question with regards to this video, please leave them in the comment section below. If you have any doubt or any video request also, you can drop it there. And please make sure you share this video. If you find value in it, please share and also subscribe to this channel.